Officials calling for a crackdown on crime as an armed robbery spree continues across Chicago.
WGN's Dana Repick is live in North Lawndale with the latest here. Dana?
Well, police believe there are multiple robbery crews targeting victims on the west side. One of those crews was caught last night, but after those arrests were made, another group was at it, hitting victims in 10 separate locations in a matter of 2 hours. A mechanic at Illinois Auto Repair on North St. Louis and Logan Square says it happened in seconds. A dark-colored sedan pulled up just before 7:30 Saturday night, and four armed men with hoods up wearing masks jump out, taking his wallet at gunpoint that had $2,000 cash a customer had just paid him inside.
No, nunca pensé que me fuera a tocar a mí.
He says he never thought it would happen to him, but this man is just one of more than a dozen people robbed in a two-day time span on the west side.
It sounds like that's been happening a lot lately. It's definitely scary.
Victims described between 2 to 5 armed offenders. In several of the incidents, they were seen fleeing in a white sedan, one victim describing it as a Kia. Just overnight, a crew committed 10 armed robberies, the first just before 3:30 this morning in the 4400 block of West 5th. The offenders hit victims on West Grand, South Campbell, Southwestern, West Cermak, South Allport, West Lake, North Ashland, and West Grenshaw. In some cases, the victims were assaulted as well.
It is a real shame that it's happening. I do wish that there would be less of this, naturally.
Chicago police did arrest 3 people around 9:30 last night after an armed robbery led to a crash in Bucktown. The suspects were in a white SUV and had just robbed a 51-year-old woman in the 2000 block of Mozart before crashing. That vehicle is possibly connected to multiple robberies over the weekend, including the one at the auto repair shop.
There was a lot of frustration because I know that the mayor's talking about investing in the community, looking at the root cause of violence, which my community supports, I think most Chicagoans support. But in the interim, what are we doing to address the issues now?
36th Ward Alderman Gilbert Villegas recently held a public safety meeting with the 12th Police District Commander. He reports residents have started a petition for the city to reopen the shuttered 13th District that closed in 2012 due to consolidation.
The lack of patrols that are in the area, what I heard over and over were complaints, and rightfully so, from the constituents that they're not seeing enough police officers in the area.
Some feel it's become a free-for-all, many fearing for their safety.
I don't think there's a target. I just think they're just doing it just because they feel like they can.
That petition to reopen the 13th District already has 1,500 signatures. Alderman Villegas hoping that it can be put as a referendum on the upcoming March 2024 ballot. Live at the 10th District, News Dana Rebick.
Robbed at gunpoint while trying to report on armed robberies in Chicago. Come back in, Ashley. Take me through it, please.
Yeah, and that news crew even noted the irony in all this. You can't make it up. A TV news crew, as you say, from the Spanish language network Univision was filming a story on the spike in robberies in Chicago when, oh yes, they were robbed at gunpoint. It happened when a reporter and photographer were getting ready for a 5 a.m. live report in Wicker Park, a section of Chicago. 3 armed men wearing ski masks pulled up in a black SUV and a gray sedan and then first demanded money from the pair before stealing 2 bags of equipment, their camera, by the way, and the photographer's backpack. No one was hurt. Police are still looking for the suspects, but there has been a crime spree in the area between Sunday afternoon and Monday morning. For example, at least 30 people were robbed or carjacked, including a news crew who was doing a story on the rise in robberies.
This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 10, verse 16. The labor of the righteous tendeth to life, the fruit of the wicked to sin. Call Layam La Abanawa Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai Bahashim Rakakradash. Double honors to the elder apostles and elder bishops of Great Millstone who rule well. Salutations to the Akim out there on the highways and the byways. Salutations to the hopeful elect. Salutations to you speckled birds, you Israelite foreigners. And shalom to the Akwaf sitting and listening in silence as the scriptures say to do so. Proverbs chapter 10, verse 16. The labor of the righteous tendeth to life, the fruit of the wicked to sin. And what you saw in those news clips and what you continue to see on the screen is some of the fruits of the wicked. And the wicked that I'm talking about in this video is the wicked of our people. Okay, and you see that their fruits, man, these young little brute beast niggas out here robbing people left and right. They even ran up on a news crew. People reporting the news, man, and took cameras, bags, everything, man. But this is just some of the fruit of the wicked, man. And, you know, they, like, again, man, Jake prospers in wickedness, man. So he multiplies and amplifies his transgressions, his iniquities, his sins in this captivity, man. Okay? And the labor of the righteous, as you know, is, I don't want to write this out, is what we're doing. Okay? Taking heed and repenting and, you know, doing the work. Okay? Let's continue, though. Let's go to the book of Ephesians, chapter 4. Verse 28, let him that stole steal no more. Let him that stole steal no more, but rather let him labor, working with his hands, the thing which is good, that he may have to give to him that needeth. Okay, so we're not supposed to be having a covetous spirit, and you're not supposed to be stealing from nobody. Okay. You know, once you come into this truth, you change your mindset. But this is what these Jakes are doing, man. They're stealing. Okay, and as it says, but rather let him labor working with his hands. So that, what does that mean? Get a goddamn job, man. Get a job. Okay, work. Okay, you know, and what you know is bullshit. You know, you got to do all this type of stuff. We're here in captivity, man. We're here to be corrected, to be reproved, to be rebuked, to go through hell, to understand why and how we went off, man. Okay, we got to suffice the right, as it says in Micah 7, verse 9, I will bear the indignation because I have transgressed against Yahweh by Hashem and Hoshai, roughly paraphrasing, man. So you're not supposed to be out here stealing, man. Okay, so let him that stole steal no more. But rather, let him labor, working with his hands. Get a damn job, Jake. Or Jake's too involved into the streets, you know. Because when I was involved in the streets, man, you actually think when you get in a job and all that and everything else, you actually think you missing out on something. When you're not missing out on a damn thing, okay? So let's continue. Because it's only going to get worse, man. Imagine when all hell break loose and Jake ain't going to be worried about, it's like Jake isn't going to be worried about stealing no daggone money. You're going to want your resources. You're going to want your food, your women, your children, all that. So like it. This is the book of 2 Esdras, chapter 4. Second Esdras chapter 4. I'm going to start off at verse 30 and then off at verse 31. For the grain of evil seed have been sown in the heart of Adam from the beginning, and how much ungodliness have it brought up unto this time, and how much shall it yet bring forth unto the time of threshing come? Ponder now by thyself how great fruit of wickedness the grain of evil seed have brought forth. So again, we can just see that elevation happening right now, man. It's getting worse and worse as we see, man. Because again, you know, Jake is out here robbing for money or anything he can get for money, but in these days to come, he's gonna be robbing for food, okay, women, children, resources, okay? Basically resources. Money is going to be obsolete very, very, very soon in the future, man. Okay? So we see this the fruit of wickedness prospering and increasing in this captivity, man. Okay, ponder now by thyself how great fruit of wickedness the grain of evil seed have brought forth. Okay, and we know Slovakia. And we know that it's, you know, it's only going to get worse in the very near future for things to come, man. Okay, it's all part of the agenda. Because Esau wants that mayhem, that chaos, that bloodshed, you know, riots, race wars, etc., man. So this is just the first stages. It's going to go to the second stage, to the third stage, to the fourth, etc. Okay, but let's continue. And Slovakia, man, I was I'm getting over some sickness, man. That's why I put up a video yesterday. I slept the whole day yesterday, the whole day. When I say the whole day, I slept the whole day yesterday. But Slovakia. This is St. John chapter 10, verse 10. The thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. Okay, the thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. Now,
then said Jesus unto them again.
Slovakia, now we know. Slovakia, now we know that's talking about Esau. But our people have what? The spirit of Esau. So without people having the spirit of Esau, they're doing the same stuff that he's doing. Okay, they, as you see in this video, they're stealing, they kill, and they destroy, man. As it says in St. John chapter 8, verse 44, ye are of your father the devil, man. Okay, so, you know, it's nothing for Jake to be a thief. It's nothing for Jake to steal and take what is not his. It's nothing for Jake to kill. Okay, it's nothing for Jake to destroy and not think twice, not think, you know, at all. So the thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy, man. And that's what we see in this video, man. You see Jake stealing. Okay, we've seen plenty of videos where, you know, Israelites have killed one another. Destroyed households, you know, taking fathers away from their children, etc. This is part of the fruit of wickedness, man. Okay, and it's only going to get worse. Let's go here real quick. Second Ezra chapter 14, verses 16 to 17. For yet greater evils than those which thou hast seen. Slovakia, 2nd Ezra 14, verse 16. For yet greater evils than those which thou hast seen happen shall be done hereafter. So what we see right now is nothing. Because again, in these days to come, in the very near future, at arm's reach, it's going to be worse. Okay? It's going to be worse out here on the streets in every 50 states in Babylon, man. Okay, it's going to be way worse. Verse 17. For look how much the world shall be weaker through age, so much the more shall evils increase upon them that dwell therein. So the evils are going to be amplified. The evils are going to be terrifying, man. Okay, it's going to be harsh. You know, days that we're going to hope and pray to Yahweh by Shem Yahawashah. It has us, you know, protected in these times, man, because it's going to be worse. What we see right now is nothing. It's literally nothing. You know, Jake running around stealing and everything else, this is nothing. Okay? Because, again, it's not going to be about money in the very near future. It's going to be about resources, your food, your bread, your women. Okay? Your alcohol, if you got it. Okay, it's going to be about resources. Okay, period, man. It's not, the money's going to be the last thing on anybody's mind. Okay, especially you two-third Israelites, man. But let's continue. So, like, yeah, I'm still getting over this little infirmities. This is 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 10. For the love of money is the root of all evil. And Jake has that concept in his mentality, man, in his heart. He loves money. Okay, and it didn't say that money's evil. It says for the love, because money can also be used as a defense. Okay, for the love of money is the root of all evil. Okay, and you seeing that right here. Look, this is what the love of money does to you right here. This is what the love of money does to you right here. Got you hopping out of vehicles to rob people, man. This is what the love of money does to you. Okay? It has you do things that you never knew that you would do. Okay? For the love of money is the root of all evil, which while some coveted after, they have erred from the faith. And, you know, this a lot of these two-thirds and, you know, people that claim they ain't the truth and love that tax-free exempt 501c3 alliance just to have a tax-free dollar and, you know, to make money, man. You know, not just Jake in the world, but, you know, people that's in this truth and also, you know, the slave plantation churches, man. They have that love of money spirit, covetous spirit, man. They're of the world, man. Okay? Again, they like their daddy Esau, man. They have erred from the faith and pierced themselves through with many sorrows, man. And you're going to be judged for all that, man, at the end of the day, man. Because, again, it's not going to be... Ain't gonna be no money in the near future. It's gonna be your resources, your wife, your food, your kids. Okay? So let's close out here. The point is made. This is the book of 2nd Esdras, chapter 16. Starting off at verse 46, ending off at 47. For strangers shall reap their fruits, okay? For strangers shall reap their fruits. And this, I'm just bringing this out to back up what I was just saying a few times. For strangers shall reap their fruits and spoil their goods, overthrow their houses, and take their children captives. For in captivity and famine shall they get children. And they that occupy their merchandise with robbery, the more they deck their cities, their houses, their possessions, and their own persons. So, it's like, in the very near future, like I just stated, that's what it's going to be about. Again, verse 46, for strangers shall reap their fruits and spoil their goods, overthrow their houses, and take their children captives, for in captivity and famine shall they get children. And they that occupy their merchandise with robbery. And that's what it's going to be about. It didn't say nothing about no gold, silver, Babylon's currency. Nah, man. This is just a beginning stage, man. In those days to come, you're going to wish you could just give them money and they just take it. Money ain't going to be worth nothing then. Okay, it's going to be your wife, your kids, your food, your necessities, whatever you got that benefits them at that time, man. Okay? Those Federal Reserve notes is going to be doo-doo in those days. But I don't want to rock this eye. I hope and I pray that this is edifying and uplifting to the true, sincere Akim Wa'akwaf. So with that, I'm just going to say, Kol Ho'layim La, Abba Nawa Yahweh Bahashim, Yahweh Shai Bahashim, Rekakwe Dash, Watha Wada Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai Bahashim Rakakra Dash for putting the spirit on me, my elder apostles, elder bishops, elders, brothers on down, for doing these epistles to enlighten you, to inform you, to edify you, and uplift you through the power and spirit and words of Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. May the blessing and election and protection be upon you and your household. Adonai Ratzah. Until the next one. So with that, I'm just going to say, Shalom.